the causes and the remedies of what? Of tribalism. Number one, what is tribalism? Before even talking about tribalism, you know that tribalism is also called what? Ethnicity. And tribalism or ethnicity is acting in favor of one's ethnic group. So it is whereby you favor your own ethnic group at the expense of the other group. So you know the people of your tribe, and you're on the side of the people of your tribe, or you favor the people of your tribe against the others, what? The other tribes. What are the causes? The causes of tribalism is, number one, there's a where you feel language dominance or the dominant language. What I'm saying is there's another one cause is dominant language. Dominant language is whereby one long language is being used by the most people. Are you understanding? Yes, one language is being used by the most people and it's widespread. So they feel because most of the people are using that language, that it is what? It's better than the other, from the other tribes or from the other ethnic communities. For example, let's say all of us were using Taita. Most of us, not all of us, were using Taita. But still here we have Kikamba, we have Kikuyu, we have the Luo. Yes, we have Luya. But you feel that at the highest percentage of the class, for example, let's say 80% are using the what? The Taita, right? The Taita language. They either, let's say Taita, they speak what? They speak Taita, right? So you feel that your language, because it's dominant, you want to group yourself as Taitas in one area. You see, it's because of your language. So you start favoring each other. Like when we are talking, instead of, because let's say I've said that 70 of the class is Taita, yes? So you feel that if someone comes and is Kikuyu, we start talking in what? Taita. Yes. You see, now we are segregating the other person, right? On basis of what? Because even that person wants to hear what you're saying, yes? Or for example, hear Kikamba. And you know very well Celestine cannot hear Kikamba. Or you know very well that Felicia cannot hear. Yet you're talking. You see how you start talking in that language. How does she know that you're not gossiping her? That is, number one, that is what exactly we call it, tribalism. Number two, another cause is colonial boundaries. That is where ethnic boundaries were used as administrative boundaries. So they caused tribalism because people are living in an area where they are living, they come from the same tribe, yes? You find that Kisis are living in one area, yes? According to the boundaries that were put there by the colonial what? Government during the Europeans. Then because they are living in one area, if you go to work there in that area, yes? They are about to work. They say, in our tribe we do this. In our tribe we do this. Yes? That is tribalism. Because they are talking of people of that tribe because they live that particular area. Yet you don't live there. Maybe you are going to work there or you are going schooling where? In that particular area. There is also number three, civil servants working in their local areas. Yes, you are bound to segregate other people who do not work there and they are not. You know, if you work in your local area, you are still going to speak your what? Your native language. When we are here, we are very prone to speak in that language, yes? Even when I'm speaking to, let's say, someone who's senior, I can speak in my language because I'm in that local, in my home local area. But if you find someone like Mr. O, Awiti, yes, he's not in the local area. Yes, I can easily be tribalistic because maybe I'm talking and he wants to do what? To hear. Yes. Then we also have tribal clubs. People form tribal clubs. You can go in an area, for example, let's say this is a national school where there are different tribes. And then we start grouping ourselves as Maasai's. And then we form a what? A club. You know, because we are from the same community, we are going to be segregating the others. Because why are we using the basis of a tribe to do what? To form a what? A club. Remedies. Remedies of tribalism. And I said these are ways that we can counteract tribalism, or we can correct. Number one is love. Loving one another. By loving one another. That is because we are Christians, we love one another. Number two, we respect different ethnic groups. Whether you are Luya, whether you are what? Is it a tribe in Swahili? You should respect each other. Also, supporting cultural programs. Because remember, these cultural programs bring about cultural integration. What do you mean by integration? Integration is whereby they bring forth programs that enable everyone to fit well in the community. Integration is that, whereby you enable everyone to fit well in the community, whether you're from whatever tribe, whichever tribe, you can be able to fit. That is depending on your culture, you can fit in any place. That is what we call integration. I also, number four, national schools. That is, you create more national schools. You know, if you are in a national school, you just have, they don't go tribalist because they are all tribes, right? Yes, create more national schools, use a common language. That's why we emphasize that you should not use a local language. You should not use Kikamba when you're here. You should not use Kikuyu when you're here. You should only use what? English and Swahili. You use a common language. You punish the perpetrators of the vice. Those who are practicing ethnicity or tribalism, we do what? They are punished. Also, inter-ethnic marriages are promoted. That is, we urge more people to marry each other from different tribes. You are Kikuyu, you marry a Maasai. Inter-ethnic marriages. And also, we encourage domestic tourism. What is domestic tourism? You know, we always think about tourism is where you go to visit, and let's say you enjoy the scenery, you view the animals. But now when you talk about domestic, is whereby, for example, you're in Kenya, you go to the Mara, yes? You go to your own what? National parks. You're promoting domestic tourism because you go to, you know, those people who are near Mara are of a different culture. So you have to learn about them, yes? And if you learn about them, you're going to love them. If you're going to Magadi, let's say for excursion or something like that, you're going to find the Maasai there, yes? You'll go to their houses and learn how they're living, like that. Go to the third, discrimination.